Hello, and a very warm welcome to LMT Royal YouTube channel. Here's why Prince Harry and Meghan Markle are leaving Instagram. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle are leaving Instagram. According to the couple's Instagram post on March 30, 2020, from their Sussex Royal Instagram handle, Markle and Harry won't be updating their official social media account anymore. The couple shared on Instagram, "Thank you to this community for the support, the inspiration, and the shared commitment to the good in the world. We look forward to reconnecting with you soon. You've been great. Until then, please take good care of yourselves and of one another." Harry and Markle posted the announcement one day before their official duties as senior members of the royal family end. According to People, a spokesperson for the couple said that Markle and Harry will also stop updating their official website, sussexroyal.com. Per the spokesperson, "Although they will be inactive, both the Instagram account and website will remain in existence online for the foreseeable future." People reports that the Sussex Royal handle was created in April 2019 after Meghan deleted her personal account. The account was launched with a welcome message and a collection of some of the couple's favorite photos. They wrote, "Welcome to our official Instagram. We look forward to sharing the work that drives us, the causes we support, important announcements, and the opportunity to shine a light on key issues. We thank you for your support and welcome you to Sussex Royal." Harry and Meghan. At the time of this writing, the post has garnered more than 1.3 million likes. In other news, what really went down between Meghan, Harry, and Trump? Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's new status as non-working members of the royal family officially begins on March 31, 2020. The couple was already living a new, more private lifestyle in Vancouver Island, Canada, but now they're making another shift. According to People, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex settled in Los Angeles with their young son Archie in March 2020. People reported, they have been living in a secluded compound and haven't ventured out amid the coronavirus pandemic. Markle grew up in Los Angeles, and her mother Doria Raglan still lives there, making it a natural choice to settle down there. That being said, the transition hasn't been without its hiccups. On March 29, 2020, President Trump took to Twitter to publicly declare that the U.S. won't pay for security protection for Meghan and Harry. President Trump tweeted, "I am a great friend and admirer of the Queen and the United Kingdom. It was reported that Harry and Meghan, who left the kingdom, would reside permanently in Canada. Now they have left Canada for the U.S. However, the U.S. will not pay for their security protection. They must pay." Let's unpack what Trump meant by this and how Markle and Harry responded. The debate over who should fund Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's security has been ongoing ever since they announced Megxit. Now that they've stepped back as senior members of the British royal family, their security costs won't be funded by the UK government. However, they're still internationally famous people with a high threat and risk level, per their website. In January 2020, there were reports that Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau tentatively agreed to fund half of the couple's security costs while they were living in Canada, per the Evening Standard. According to CBC, Trudeau later clarified that a decision had not yet been reached.
"I think most Canadians are very supportive of having you know, royals be here. There is a general feeling of appreciation for the Sussexes."
Additionally, the outlet reports that the Canadian government had been providing Markle and Harry with intermittent security since November 2019, but that was because they were still technically working royals until the end of March 2020. Now that the couple is living in the US, the debate has crossed the border. On Monday, March 30, 2020, just one day after President Trump's tweet, a spokesperson for the Sussexes responded to the president's concerns. The spokesperson told Fox News, "The Duke and Duchess of Sussex have no plans to ask the US government for security resources. Privately funded security arrangements have been made. We probably won't find out any details anytime soon, seeing as how giving out security details to the public would be pretty counterproductive. However, we're glad that this potential feud has been squashed so quickly. Another analysis: the truth about Meghan Markle's new job at Disney. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry's Megxit from the royal family officially goes into effect on March 31, 2020. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex completed their final royal duties in early March 2020, and will relinquish the royal titles, HRH, His and Her Royal Highness. They've already moved from their royal home in the United Kingdom to Los Angeles, US. Meghan and Harry will no longer be on the royal family's payroll, and instead, they plan to earn their own income. That means, yep, getting jobs. Meghan has already secured her first job since starting over as a pseudo-commoner, and it's definitely not an entry-level gig. Meghan is narrating an upcoming documentary for Disney. The trailer just dropped, and it's due to arrive on the Disney Plus streaming service on April 3, 2020. Here's everything you need to know about Meghan's new Disney gig. Meghan Markle's upcoming Disney-nature documentary is called Elephants. It follows members of an elephant family as they make a grueling 1,000-mile journey across Africa's Kalahari Desert. Disney-nature shared the news and trailer on March 26, 2020, announcing that the film, narrated by the Duchess of Sussex, will premiere alongside another film about dolphins that is narrated by Natalie Portman. People reported that the documentary will benefit Elephants Without Borders, EWB, a conservation charity that Meghan and Harry have worked with in the past. In 2017, the couple traveled to Botswana to help an EWB doctor, Dr. Mike Chase, place trackers on elephants to help protect them from poachers. The Sussexes shared photos of the trip on World Elephant Day in 2019. Considering Meghan's new life away from the royal family just got started, this new project may seem a little sudden, but her collaboration with Disney has reportedly been in the works for a long time. Elephant filmmakers Mark and Vanessa Berlowitz approached Meghan to do the project in the summer of 2019, according to People, and she recorded the narration that autumn in London. It's not entirely clear whether this is a paid job or a passion project, but the Times reported that Meghan's compensation will be donated to EWB. There has long been speculation that Meghan Markle planned to narrate a film for Disney, though fans weren't sure what the movie would be. Around July 2019, a video began circulating on Twitter showing Prince Harry seemingly touting Meghan's voiceover skills to the CEO of Disney, Bob Iger, during the premiere of The Lion King. "You know she does voice-overs," Prince Harry tells Iger in the clip, adding that his wife is really interested. Iger replies, "We'd love to try." Then, just days after Megxit was announced in January 2020, news of the Disney deal made headlines. Is the clip a coincidence, or did the Duke of Sussex help get his wife the coolest job ever? We may never know for sure, but people reported that the Elephants project is the only deal between Meghan and Disney at this time, despite speculative reporting and rumors that she may be difficult to work with. Another report: the real reason Meghan Markle and Harry are in a better place with the royal family. If family members are willing to work through their differences and see things from each other's perspectives, most issues can be overcome. That seems to apply to the royals in Britain as well. The monarchy was thrown into turmoil when Prince Harry and Meghan Markle announced in January 2020 that they were stepping back from their official roles and duties. While the situation appeared to be quite dire for a while, and included a possible punishment as well as an awkward encounter, the family now seems to be focused on trying to move forward. According to a source who opened up to Entertainment Tonight on March 23, 2020, things are in a better space now between the couple and the royal family. While of course there have been tensions, the family is getting through it. This is surely a good thing for Harry, who is reportedly having a hard time leaving his family, and may have been suffering in the aftermath of Megxit. These days, he's likely feeling pretty darn great if he's adjusting to his new life as well as his wife seems to be. Please support growing LMD Royal Channel by subscribe channel, like and share videos us. Your support is the motivation for us to produce better videos. If you have any suggestions for us, please leave your comments below.
Stop.
Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more LMT Royal videos about your favorite royals are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.